Skies are crying, I'm watching, catching teardrops in my hands.
Guys, my name is Shae, and if you've been watching my YouTube channel, you know that I left you guys on a cliffhanger. The reason why I stopped filming videos altogether is because I just wasn't happy, and I was telling my story, and my story was depressing me. Like crazy, I would film the video, I would cry during the video, I would cry after, and then I would have to go and edit it, and I would just cry. And I think the reason why I was so unhappy was because I was living it. And when I had to go back into the past and just think about all this stuff that I had gone through, it was just making me very sad and just made me realize how normal my life wasn't. You know, at that time, I had to stop school for a little bit. I wasn't able to work. I wasn't able to drive. So I was really just out of, like, normalcy for a year. And it was just really sad to me. And I couldn't face the comments that you guys were leaving. They were beautiful. And thank you to everyone who prayed for me. But it was just kind of too much too soon. So now I'm back, and I don't really want to talk about everything that I've gone through. I don't mind sharing my story, you know, it's already on the internet, but I have definitely moved on since then, and I feel like I've become a better person, so I don't really want to talk about it right now. but I do want to continue my YouTube channel and show people that are sick like I was, because a lot of people have reached out to me. Spoonie, what's up? I just want to show, like, you can still be sick or ill and live a normal life. And when I was going through it, I was just like, I'm never going to be normal again. This is my life. I'm going to live in my bed forever, and my parents are going to have to take care of me for the rest of my life. Like that, like, I'm being dramatic, but that is exactly how I thought. I thought I was never gonna be normal and do the things that I'm doing right now. So I kind of just want to give you guys an update on my life and what has been going on. So I have this spot, is what I call it. So the doctors call it a tumor. I don't like that word, so my other word is the spot. And so I go for MRIs every 3 months, either 3 or 4 months, and get checked out to make sure that the spot hasn't grown. And the great news is it has not grown. And a couple of weeks ago, I have just been told that I can move to every 6 months. So the next time I go for an MRI will be in January, which I'm so happy about because I'm claustrophobic. And if you've ever had an MRI, you know why I'm happy. But I'm also happy because it hasn't grown. As for everything that I was experiencing, I still have a headache all the time. I think I'm just a little bit used to it and kind of put it in the back of my head. I still get the really sharp pains every once in a while, but I notice that I get them if I'm working too hard or not resting or just pushing myself too hard. So I just have to, like, calm down and just relax for a minute, and it usually goes away. I'm still taking medication. My right eye is still blurry, but I'm driving, so that's good. And what else? I still get body aches. My hands and feet swell up like crazy, but I still wear heels like a crazy person. I still wear rings like a crazy person, but, you know, whatever, I'm a girl. What else? Oh, so I am back in school. I started off with online classes, and right now I'm taking history, which probably wasn't the best class to take online because it's a lot of reading, and the class is in a month, so you're taking a whole semester in a month. But I've actually learned a lot just from reading on my own and not having a teacher, so I kind of like it, but I don't like the papers that I have to write. And I am working. I am a nanny for this wonderful family. And basically, you know, I just take care of their kids. And then I'm an occasional babysitter for a couple other families. And I bake and I sell my cupcakes, some cake pops. If you follow me on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram, you've seen some of the creations that I've created, and I sell those, and I have my little business, and I have business cards. Like, I'm really official. Yeah, I'm official. but yeah, so I've been doing that, and I'm also a virtual personal assistant for a couple of people. I just do emails and data entry and, you know, whatever is kind of needed for me, and I can do that from home. So I'm still home-based a lot, but I do get out a little bit more than obviously I was. Some other things that are going on in my life. If you know me personally, you know that I want to be an actress, and that is all that I really want to do in life. When I was sick, I was just straight up like, it's not happening. Like, I'm never going to be an actress. I'm never going to be on TV. Just got to face the facts. And then I was watching Juliana Rancic, who I've always watched a reality show with her husband, Bill Rancic. And she, you know, was diagnosed with breast cancer. But she just kept working. Like, she would go and have a surgery, and a couple weeks later she would be back on TV, and I was just like, how is she doing that? Like, you know, I've been sitting in my bed for a year moping. So I finally was just like, Shae, get off your butt, and I prayed about it, and so I got off my butt, and I just basically changed my mind frame, and I wasn't letting myself say that I was sick anymore. I was just like, I'm better, I'm healthy. In reality, I wasn't, but I was telling myself that I was, and I think that that definitely helped with the mental health. So I just spaced. What happened? You know what I'm really trying to do? I'm trying not to cry because my life is crazy changed. It's changed so much. So I, like, blah, blah, blah. So I got off my butt, and, you know, watching her True Hollywood Story, if you haven't seen it, it's a must-see. Like, no matter what field you're in, if you're sick, if you're not sick, I think it's a very inspirational story, and she really inspired me to get back to work. So since I've been sick with my acting career, it is definitely taking off. I'm very excited. I have a couple of projects coming up, which is exciting, and yeah, like, my life is definitely really good right now. My relationship with God has just been amazing and just, like, real. I'm very grateful for everything in my life. I'm grateful that I got sick, because I don't think, if I hadn't gotten sick, I probably would not be so adamant about my education, adamant about my acting and actually doing it. Like, I am starting to live my dream, and that is very crazy for me. So I am excited about life again. I'm trying not to cry. I will not cry. So yeah, I'm very, very excited about my life, and I had something else to say and I can't remember what it was. I don't know, but I do want to make more regular videos and just keep you guys updated on what's going on in my life. I know that a lot of people out there care about me and have watched my videos, and I just want to say thank you for everyone who sent me text messages, emails, comments, and praying for me and really being there for me. It meant a lot. Even if I never replied, I was just really in a funk, and I didn't want to talk about me being sick or anything. So thank you so much. I really do appreciate it, and I am better than ever and loving life. So you definitely contribute to that, and I was very, very blessed to have all of you guys rooting for me.
Skies are crying, I'm watching, catching teardrops in my